Yeah, so are we going to be able to collect data all along it with our sensors, or is it maybe set points?
So I used to be an engineer for ExxonMobil, and Exxon does a fantastic job of training their engineers, not just on a single engineering piece, but throughout the company. My name is Dianna Liu. I'm a second year student at Yale SOM, and I'm the founder of Arix Technologies. So they started me on their business side, and then they moved me to one of the refineries down in Louisiana for some of the on-the-ground experience of how to be, you know, an engineer and actually how does the manufacturing operations work. That's when I really saw how corrosion affected not just the engineer's job, but really affected every single part of the company. Corrosion actually affects 3% of the world's GDP. A lot of it is in manufacturing, in infrastructure, and utilities. These refineries do their best to try to mitigate the effects of corrosion, but ultimately they're really limited by what technology is available, not by their willingness to use the technology.
The servos take a lower voltage.
These aluminum extrusions here with fins that you can see are the...
We're making a pipe crawling robot for manufacturing settings primarily to check for inspection data. So what we're looking at first is specifically corrosion in refineries. We have two provisional patents filed. And with these prototypes, we're actually talking with several major oil and gas companies on field testing or customer testing, and they've been very receptive and they want to stay involved. To be honest, I initially was thinking, why don't I just do this myself without business school? I saw some information about how SOM was very integrated into the greater Yale community and thought that actually might be the best way to find really smart engineers who would be interested in working with something like this.
Yeah, I think we could stack these in a different way, either use like a multi-layered
this is board
pretty or something.
Inefficient use of space in terms
so
of...
So when I showed up at SOM, I went to the undergrad campus and started networking with engineers. And then found two engineers just really blew me out of the water. They were brilliant, they were very interested in doing something like this, and they had the internal drive. The community is just very, very supportive. You have the enthusiasm of people who know nothing about engineering, who want to get involved. Everyone's willing to step outside their comfort zone and really learn and help and offer their support however they can. So, you know, we have a friend who used to be an accountant for a major accounting firm, and she's been very helpful in helping us understand things I never would have known. I was very impressed with how great the entrepreneurship program at SOM was. There's some amazing professors. Kyle Jensen and Jennifer McFadden work with students one-on-one, and they provide a lot of, you know, very tailored support to what you're working on. The ability to have a place to work, to be able to have machine shop space for free that we've been able to prototype at, this is in the tens of thousands of dollars that we're saving just by being here. The ability to meet so many other entrepreneurs and have access to that Yale network. So this network of not only other entrepreneurs, but investors. So I am so glad I came here, and I'm really grateful for the opportunity.